a very personally challenging weekend, and it started Friday morning when I found out that my grandmother was passing away, and she passed away Saturday morning. So that kind of started me thinking, because when you have an experience like that, full in a place full of friends, but no family, you start really thinking about who you are. And it made me really consider the growth I've had in this community. And then we had Mr. Wilson speak on Saturday, and he said something. He said, you know, what keeps people from going out and talking to other people and asking and helping is your fears, and we have to overcome those fears. It's a paraphrase. And then we had Ms. Zager on Sunday say, do elementary teachers ever get in their cars and drive to the high school? And do high school teachers ever get in their cars and drive to the elementary schools and ask questions? And the answer was no, because they're afraid. And it made me think even harder about my growth and my fears. And I realized that 4.5 years ago, my fear was you. No joke. I'm an incredible introvert. No one in this room would ever know that.
Plus, we're scary.
I cannot stand to be in a room with other people. You're laughing, it's not
good. I'm just thinking we're smart.
And 4.5 years ago, I realized that and I decided that I had to do something. This was about December. And these weirdos on the internet that I can totally communicate with just fine, because I don't have to be in the same room with them, were talking about meeting up, and I said, I need to do something about that. I need to face this fear. So that brings me to yesterday's keynote, where Mr. Kane talked about your comfort zone. And it said, you know, you gotta live outside your comfort zone sometimes. Well, 4.5 years ago, I made a decision in December to live outside my comfort zone and challenge that fear. So along comes July. Got on my motorcycle. I didn't fly. Right? Now, this was a conscious decision. I didn't fly, because when you fly, you're there, you're stuck. But when you're on your motorcycle, you can give up at any time. Okay?
And wear chaps.
And wear chaps. So I got on my motorcycle and I left for Reno. And my map said 1,850 miles. Now, I have a 5-gallon tank. That's a lot of stopping. Okay. Not only does your butt get sore on a motorcycle, but there's a lot of stopping to fill up for gas. And every single time I stopped, I sat down on my motorcycle and I said, you can give up right now. You can turn around and no one will ever care. And no one will ever know.
I don't know.
And I sat there on the motorcycle and I hit the button to turn it on and I kept going. And every morning leaving the hotel, I said, you can turn around right now and no one will ever care and no one will ever know. And I had that conversation with myself about 50 times over those 3 days it took to get there. See, and that's important to this facing your fears, because you don't face your fears once and beat them. You have to face your fears regularly to beat them. And then I drove into the hotel parking lot. And in the hotel parking lot, I sat there and I said, you can turn around right now. And no one will ever care, and no one will ever know. And I sat there, and I've told a couple of people this, because I realize this, but there's no one else has ever heard this story, not even my wife. But I actually sat there in the parking lot for about 5 minutes, because I could have turned around right then and there, and no one would have ever cared, and no one would have ever known. My wife would have been like, yeah, that's cool, that's a good motorcycle ride. Come on home. And instead, I did the most courageous thing I've ever done in my life. And it sounds weird, because people do courageous things all the time that are amazing, So for me, the most courageous thing I've ever done in my life was to walk through the doors of the hotel lobby. And I faced that fear. And facing that fear allowed me to do something amazing for myself. And it connects with Mr. Wilson, and it connects with Ms. Egan, and it connects with Mr. King, because it's always fear that holds us back of accomplishing things. So I walked through that door, and I met some really cool people, and I got hugged, and all of a sudden that fear just evaporated because it was that personal touch. And then I went back home, and in my district, I was the only person on Twitter, I was the only person really pushing an aggressive, progressive math platform and agenda, and I said, oh, no one's going to listen to me. And then I said, screw that. That is bullshit. Who really gives a rat's ass if anyone listens to me? Because I walked through those frickin' doors, and all of a sudden there was a weekly email going out to every single department chair in my district and every single member of my department and my administrator saying, hey, here's this cool thing I found this week, you should try it. And every single week that went out, pretty soon my district was like, hey, you know, if you really want to know about really good math teaching, you go see Glenn. And then I got involved in this community more and more and more, and I started doing more and more things, and then it led to the university starting to pay attention to me. And you know, you get that little voice going, no, I don't really need to go teach that class, you know, that they're inviting me to. That would be really scary. It was like, screw that. I walked through the doors. I can do it. And then someone's like, you know, you should really do a PhD. I'm like, no, that's scary. Screw that. I walked through the doors. You have to face your fears. Fears for Mr. Wilson is what keeps people from connecting and overcoming our gaps. Fears are what keeps middle school teachers and high school teachers and elementary school teachers from talking because we're afraid of each other. And fears, most importantly, are what keeps ourselves from reaching the potentials that we can reach. And so it's very meta, very different than everything else that's been presented today because it's very personal. My personal challenge to everyone is find your fear. Find your fear and overcome it. Do whatever it takes to overcome it. And if it's a 3-day motorcycle ride where you stop every 2 hours and challenge yourself to keep going, do it. Don't do it in July.